Let's have a closer look at DCC packets using a logic analyzer. I've taken Dave Falkenberg's schematics that are normally used to connect DCC to an Arduino. I've built the interface on a breadboard. Track power and DCC are supplied by my IntelliBox. The Arduino is only here to provide 5 volts to the optocoupler and the rest of the schematics. On the left, you will see my cheap but trusty USB logic analyzer. Now, let's see what happens when we enable track power. First, I'll start a packet capture on my logic analyzer. The NRA has put the standards and recommended practices up on their website. And I will put the links down below. Section 9.2 describes the DCC communication standard. And according to the communication standard, a packet must start with a preamble. So a preamble is only there to indicate the start of a new DCC packet. The preamble to a packet consists of a sequence of value 1 bits. A command station must send a minimum of 14 full preamble bits. In my previous video about the Arduino DCC monitor, the monitor also reported the preamble size, in my case 26 bits. Let's have a look at the packets captured by our logic analyzer. So, let's browse through our capture. We are looking for the preamble and it should consist of a sequence formed by a lot of ones. This looks like one. Let's count the value 1 bits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Exactly what our Arduino DCC monitor was telling us. So it seems like my IntelliBox sends out 26 preamble bits. Now that we've looked at the preamble, let's have a look at locomotive data packets. To do so, I will select the locomotive on my IntelliBox. In this case, I will be using address 28. And I will enable the front light function. Next, I'll start a new packet capture on the logic analyzer. As we did before, let's zoom into the packets. A little bit further up the stream. And let's see if we can recognize the preamble. There it is. This looks like a preamble. After the preamble, there should be a packet start bit, and then we should count 8 bits to form the first byte. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the first byte. And it looks like the byte consists of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Now let's put that into a calculator. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0 makes address 28, the same as we had selected on the IntelliBox. Now let's look at the second byte. When we open the NMRA extended standard, there is a section about function group 1 instructions. And they start with 100. If bit 1 of CV29 has a value of 1, which happens to be the case in my locomotive decoder, bit 4 of DCC byte 2 will control the front light. Let's return to the logic analyzer and find a second byte that starts with 100. And we have seemed to have found one. This is the preamble, our first byte, which contains the address, and the second byte starting with 1001. If we count back, this should be the fourth bit. And remember, we have to start counting from 0 instead of 1. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the bit that controls the front light, exactly as the DCC standard describes. If you want to know more about the DCC standard, follow the links down below to the NMRA website. And if you like this video, like, comment or subscribe.